Hello everyone, welcome to GK lecture series. In this particular video, we are going to look at the GK sections in past three CLAT papers, that is CLAT 2017, 16 and 15. The objective of this exercise is to analyze the types of questions and the nature of questions being asked in the examination, the types of answer options provided, and most importantly, to look for a pattern so that an appropriate strategy can be devised around that pattern. So what we are going to do is look at CLAT past year papers and divide the questions on the basis of certain themes. Let us begin our analysis with the first theme, which is sports. Sports-based questions are a favorite of CLAT examiner every year. So you can be sure that every year there would be at least 3 to 4 questions which are based on sports. Now, the sports-based question, they have certain subsections. Generally, the questions from the sports theme are asked on the basis of important events, their winners, their runner-ups, the nationalities of both winners as well as runner-ups. Apart from that, the hosting sites or venues of important sporting events like Olympics or maybe Asian Games. Apart from that, some section in sports theme is also on the basis of certain specific sport-based terminology. We are going to look at some of the questions from past CLAT to look at this point or to emphasize this point. Here are some of the questions. So, for example, in CLAT 2017, we had a question asking about scorpion kick is a phrase used in which of the following sport? Options given were kabaddi, kickboxing, kallari fight, which is a South Indian martial art form, and kung fu, which is another martial art form. This question was slightly controversial also because the option given was kung fu, while scorpion kick is a term used in kabaddi also. So CLAT committee had to change the answer of this question later on. Similarly, in CLAT 2015, we had a question asking us about that sneakometer is a device associated with which sport. Options were tennis, cricket, hockey and football. Whenever there is an important sporting event happening, like in Olympic Games or maybe Paralympics or Commonwealth Games or Asian Games, the news related to these events become very, very important. For example, in 2016, when we had Olympics held in Rio, in the same year, there were at least 2 questions in CLAT from Olympics. One of which was that which personality has actually lighted the torch or the Olympic flame. Another question had an Indian origin where they asked that Deepa Karmakar, the very famous Indian sports person, is associated with which of the following sport? You know that Deepa Karmakar, who is a gymnast, she created history by becoming the first Indian women gymnast to be qualified for Olympics. So a question about Deepa Karmakar was very much on expected lines and it also figured in the examination. 2 other important areas within sports are A, whenever any major sport award is announced. For example, in 2016, we had a question in CLAT about who was the winner of Rajiv Gandhi Khel Ratna Award. Rajiv Gandhi Khel Ratna Award, incidentally, is the highest sport award of our country. And in 2016, the winner was Sania Mirza. Similarly, in 2015, we had another question on inclusion of an Indian cricketer into ICC Hall of the Fame. So, questions which are based on important sports achievement or important sports award are also important. Another theme in sport is whenever an Indian make any record or any significant achievement at international level, that becomes very, very important from exams point of view, and you can be sure that that kind of question would definitely be there in your CLAT paper. For example, in 2016, there was a question about Neeraj Chopra, the Indian javelin thrower who created world record in under 20 world championship. Now, this is such a big achievement that there has to be a question in examination based on Neeraj Chopra, and it was there. And lastly, please remember in sports that those sporting disciplines are more important from exams point of view, in which India has done some kind of good achievement in last couple of years. For example, disciplines like cricket or maybe badminton, or increasingly nowadays, kabaddi. After sports, another theme that I have picked up is government policies and schemes. This government policies and schemes section is also one of the favorite with CLAT examiner, and you can expect that 3 to 4 questions every year would be asked from this theme. Though there were no questions in CLAT 2017 from government schemes and policies, but in both CLAT 2016 as well as 2015, there were 3 questions each from this section on government schemes and policies. And out of these 3 questions, 2 questions were based on the new schemes launched by government in that 1 year, and 1 question was on the basis of a new regulation issued by Finance Ministry. Let us look at how easy or difficult were these questions. CLAT 2016 had a question that Prime Minister Narendra Modi launched a new campaign titled Startup India, Stand Up India. The question was, this campaign is aimed at A. making India digital, B. promoting bank financing for startups and offer incentives to boost entrepreneurship and job creation, C. promoting Swachh Bharat, and D. promoting free education to all children. Similarly, another question in the same year was, Prime Minister Narendra Modi launched an ambitious program named Setu Bharatam. What is the objective of this program? A. linking all major cities and towns by rail, air and road by 2019. B. making all national highway railway crossing free by 2019. C. providing travel concession to senior citizens throughout India. And D. providing travel concession to women and children throughout India. So these were the questions about 2 new government schemes in 2016. Similarly, 2015 had a question on Prime Minister's newly launched program Give It Up campaign. The question was, Prime Minister is urging Indians to give up what of the following? A. tobacco products, B. LPG subsidy, C. use of incandescent bulb, and D. use of plastics. And another question was on Paramparagat Krishi Vikas Yojana. It was aimed to boost A. organic farming, B. drip irrigation, C. horticultural crops, or D. vegetable crops. Now let us look at these questions one by one individually. Now the questions related to Startup India, Stand Up India program had one of the option in which the word startup was mentioned. Rest 3 options were very irrelevant. So this was an easy question with the obvious answer that option number B, which is stating that this is a program which incentivizes entrepreneurs and job creators, would be the correct answer. Similarly, with regard to the question based on Paramparagat Krishi Vikas Yojana, launched by government in 2015. Now, if you look at the meaning of this word Paramparagat, that means traditional. Krishi means agriculture, Vikas is development. So the meaning becomes a scheme to promote the traditional way of agriculture in India. So if you get the meaning of this term Paramparagat, now you know that answer should be organic farming. So this is how you answer some of those questions which you may not be very sure about, but if you apply your mind slightly, you can reach to an answer. There were 2 questions which were based on the new regulations passed by Finance Ministry, one of which was, in an attempt to curb black money, the government has made PAN card mandatory for all financial transactions exceeding rupees A 4 lakhs, B 3 lakhs, C 2 lakhs, or D 1 lakh. And another question was on the basis of which committee was constituted by RBI to review the governance of the boards of banks in India? And the option given were PJ Nayak Committee, HR Khan Committee, Harsh Vardhan Committee and K Subramaniam Committee. So by mentioning these questions, the point that I'm trying to make here is that questions from government schemes and programs could be both simple, like the ones based on the very famous or highly publicized government schemes, and it may be slightly complicated also because they may pick up an obscure government policy or an announcement by one of the ministry and to frame a question around that. So you be careful while preparing government schemes and policy announcements by different ministries. The next theme that we are going to talk about is international news. Again, one of the favorite with the examiner. You can expect another 3 to 4 questions every year from international events. The questions in this section are generally based on the new elections or the resignations or the regime change in different countries, the controversies or disputes between the countries, and also the questions related to the visits of foreign dignitaries in India. CLAT 2017 itself had 3 questions based on the elections of president in 3 countries, USA, France, and Myanmar, all 3 of which were actually expected. Let us look at these questions. So there was a question about the election of Donald Trump in USA, and the question was, Trump is president number which of USA? Choices were slightly narrow, like 43rd, 44th, 45th and 46th. Correct answer obviously is 45th, but you need to be very precise about news items like these. Similarly, there was another question about naming or identifying the president of France who is likely to take oath in May 2017. Now they are using the word likely because CLAT was actually held a week prior to the oath taking ceremony of the new French president. Option choices given were Emmanuel Macron, Francois Fillon, Marine Le Pen and Francois Hollande. Now the election of French president is such highly publicized event that most of the regular newspaper reader know about the name of the new French president, who was option number A, Emmanuel Macron. Similarly, there was a third question on the basis of election to the post of president in one of India's neighboring country, that is Myanmar. Myanmar's election was also in news highlight because this was the first election in Myanmar after more than half a century. So obviously this was also in news, and like that, most of the students were already aware of that. So this was also a predictable question. In CLAT 2016, there was also 2 questions related to the elections of president in 2 of India's neighbors, like Sri Lanka and Nepal. Let us look at these questions and look at their answers. Now these are not very difficult questions. From international news, another expected question in CLAT 2017 was about Kulbhushan Jadhav's conviction by a court in Pakistan and a subsequent stay on the execution of his sentence by an international court. So the question was about which court has passed this stay order. This was also expected. Question is easy also because the answer everybody knows is International Court of Justice. Then there are few tricky questions from international news. Have a sample of that. In CLAT 2017, there was a question about the visit of China's foreign minister to India and about a statement made by him. So the question was, which of the following individual was called a deceptive actor by China's foreign minister during March 2017? And the option given were Narendra Modi, Dalai Lama, Sirisena, who is the new president of Sri Lanka, and D, Donald Trump. Another difficult question from international news was from CLAT 2015, and the question was, Greece and Turkey, they are working to resolve their dispute over sovereignty and other rights in area related to which sea? Now this is a difficult question. right? And the point here is that while preparing international news, you must be very careful to pick up the controversies, disputes, and news related to the visits of foreign dignitaries. Next category is science and technology based question. In this category, the questions are asked on the basis of the basic concepts of science. However, the major focus in this area is new technologies and their development and questions related to them. In CLAT 2016 and CLAT 2015, there were two questions each from technology related areas. However, CLAT 2017 was filled with such questions. There were seven questions from science and technology, and which were not easy. However, the three of these questions were doable with some smart thinking. Let us look at these questions. So there were two questions based on a new software program and a new robot. One question was, Coin is developed by JP Morgan, which is a new software program to support which of the following? And another question was, what is the name of the first artificial intelligence robot to help or to assist lawyers in their work? Choices given were IBM LabBrain, Watson, Boss, and Ross. These two were difficult questions, and those who are aware of these or those who are inclined towards science and technology would only be able to answer these questions. So, some of the questions in CLAT 2017 from science and technology field were actually very difficult. However, let us look at some other questions which, though appear difficult, can be solved if you apply your mind. So one such question was, NASA rediscovered India's lunar spacecraft that was lost in the space during the past 8 years. Students have to tell the name of that spacecraft. Choices given were Mangalyaan 1, Mangalyaan 2, Chandrayaan 1, and Chandrayaan 2. Now, this question is a deceptive question because it is actually easy. Because look at the hint word, which is lost since 8 years. Now, you know that just a couple of years ago, India launched its first Mars mission or Mangalyaan. So that news is only 2 years old. That means the answer could not be either Mangalyaan 1 or Mangalyaan 2. It has to be between Chandrayaan 1 or Chandrayaan 2. Now the question says that the yaan or the spacecraft was lost 8 years ago. That means it should be a news some 10 years old. However, the news related to Chandrayaan, even if you do not remember the exact year, you know that are not as old as 10 years. That means the answer should be Chandrayaan 1. There was another question in CLAT 2017 related to Prithvi Defense Vehicle. The question was, Prithvi Defense Vehicle is A, name of an amphibious naval vessel, B, name of India's newly developed tank, C, name of a single-seated aircraft developed by Hindustan Aeronautics Limited, and D, name of India's nuclear interceptor missile. Now, probably you do not understand the meaning of the technical terms used here, like an amphibious vessel or maybe interceptor, but most likely you are aware that Prithvi is the name of a missile, and there is only one option like that given in this question. So option D is the correct answer, that Prithvi is India's nuclear interceptor missile. So this is how you can solve some questions with your presence of mind also, even if you do not know the exact answer to those questions. In the last, there is another category which is very frequently asked in CLAT examination. I have categorized it as miscellaneous questions, and this category involves questions related to highest, longest, first, biggest, these kind of news items. For example, the highest motorable road in India or the world's highest river bridge. Questions related to this are very frequent, so pay special attention while you are reading newspapers. Let us have a sample of some of these questions in previous CLAT papers. So in CLAT 2017, there was a question about naming the first country in the world that has completely switched to FM mode or the frequency modulation mode for all its digital audio broadcasting. Or there was another question about the world's longest all-women non-stop flight from New Delhi to San Francisco. There was another expected question on world's longest tunnel, but the question was tricky in the sense that they have not asked about the name of the tunnel, they have asked about the actual length of the tunnel. In CLAT 2016 also, there were a couple of questions like the one on world's first parliament to be completely run on solar power, or India's first state to introduce compulsory gender education at graduate level. In CLAT 2015 also, there was one such question. It was name India's first fully Wi-Fi enabled metro city. So you see that these questions based on highest, longest, first, biggest, world record are frequent occurrence in CLAT paper. So as I mentioned earlier, whenever you are reading newspaper, make a special note of news like these one. So this was the analysis of the CLAT paper in some of the past years. I have tried to explore themes like sports, international news, science and technology, government policies and scheme, and some miscellaneous news also. I tried to give you an idea about the types of questions and their level of difficulty in CLAT examination. One observation is that over the year, the level of difficulty and nature of complication of the questions is steadily increasing in CLAT. We would keep on exploring more such themes in future, so stay tuned. Thanks for watching.